It's unfortunate because during COVID, the least a leader would do in an environment that he is tasked to ensure the observance and compliance of those he is leading in respect of the COVID protocols would be, you know, would not be to actually break these protocols in the full air if you like, his constituents. And so it doesn't matter well for leadership, because the person being seen to be breaking the protocols is the one, the very one who is in charge of ensuring that the protocols are observed in the institution. And that is why for us, it is very unfortunate. Indeed, we have since petitioned the Ghana Tertiary Education Commission, which is the regulator of tertiary institutions in Ghana. St. Monica's College of Education is a tertiary institution under the regulation of the Ghana Tertiary Education Commission, formerly called the National Council for Tertiary Education. We are formally petitioning the Director General to externally investigate this particular conduct and not only sanction as appropriate, but also make a determination as to whether forcibly kissing students is a permitted practice in tertiary institutions.
So you want the service to educate us to find out if indeed it is a practice to kiss students on the lips. But what I want to know from you is that, aside from the issues you raised about COVID, is it ethical for something like this to happen in the school?
Exactly. So that is the question we are asking the Ghana Tertiary Education Commission, the regulator of tertiary institutions, that it should, as part of its investigation, make a pronouncement as to whether it is an acceptable ethical practice in public tertiary institutions for lecturers or for staff of the institution to forcibly kiss their students in public under the guise of a religious ritual. That determination has to be made by the Ghana Tertiary Education Commission.
Okay.
Because, as we are informed, it is his justification was a religious one. So to the extent that the institution is a faith-based institution, we need that pronouncement to guide not only the Anglican Church or its schools, but also other faith-based institutions that may be involved in other practices that may not be ethically acceptable by the Ghana Tertiary Education Commission's own standards in managing tertiary institutions in the public sector of Ghana.
Right. Now, I don't know if you've seen the response from some students. Some of the students say that the Reverend was simply awarding these students, and I've even seen a statement which is purported to be from concerned students. We are yet to verify if it's indeed from the school. But they say that we should not criticize him. He was just awarding them for doing well. So this was his way of awarding them.
Exactly. It is in recognition of the suspicion that this is not a new practice. We have read several commentary on social media about people who have known the Reverend, who I'm told is also a lawyer, and also other students in the school, suggest that this is not the first time it is happening. That it's actually a practice that he really engaged in. So the issue is that once it is imagined that this is a regular practice for the Reverend, and it's likely to be a regular practice for other people who may believe in such religious rituals, it is proper for the regulator of tertiary institutions to intervene and make a pronouncement that validates that particular practice or conduct, or invalidates it. Because at the point, there must be a balance between what is seen as a religious practice acceptable within the religious circles and what is also seen as an acceptable ethic within our public tertiary education space. This is not two different This is not too different from the issues of religious rights that we experience in West Lagos and all that. Practices that are backed by religious beliefs, okay, must situate within the ethics of the Ghanaian society. But because GES is responsible for secondary schools, they have been handling that one. This is a tertiary institution, and it falls within the remit of the Ghana Tertiary Education Commission to determine whether or not such practices are acceptable when it comes to code of conduct for tertiary institutions or staff of tertiary institutions who are by extension staff of the Ministry of Education.